Markets are hitting a new high now, both sides, S&P and Nasdaq, and I'm done trading for the day. As you can see here, I'm up over $15,000, and I've got a bit more running on my open trades because I'm still short FSLY and also short WDC. So let me quickly go through some of my trades today. As you can see here, I have a loser in SQ and a winner in WDC, but the end result is great. And that's mainly because of my second FSLY trade. Let me first go through this one. A big gap down today in FSLY, which triggered a short trade, which was the right thing to do. I mean, you've got a big gap down, you should be shorting it, expecting a gap and go. The only problem was the timing, and that's where we could go wrong several times, but you expect it to continue coming down later, even though it took off and moved over the highs and stopped my first trade. You continue expecting it to fail, and it did fail. And that trade was posted once more under 90.30, and that was my second trade. Initially, tried to move higher, failed again, and that's the part where I really liked what I did today. I mean, my best decision today was to add to this winning trade under 90. I do not add to a losing trade. I always add to a winning trade. So it's not like averaging down my losses, actually making my winners looking better. So that point here at 90, look at that point over here when it broke down under the recent support here at 90. Once it came down, it continued to come down. So that was another 3.5, almost 4 points move here, which made my second trade in FSLY, especially after I added a very big winner, which was enough to cover my first loss and much more than that. So that was the trade today with a big gap down, a gap and go, adding to a winner, and that was a very nice trade. Now I did also like WDC, that was posted here under 38. I think Zen posted it also. Some of you guys noticed it. WDC under $38. A very, very nice technical formation here. A bit of a pullback, but then it continued. If you look at the trend of WDC, it should get the best trend reward of the day, something like that. Anyway, it's a beautiful downside trade, and I'm still riding it. So a nice winner in WDC. Now, what happened in SQ? That's also quite interesting. Stock is up quite a bit and the market's trending higher. So why did I have a loser in SQ? Well, the thing is, you never know. You never know where things are going to change. You never know when pullback is going to happen. And I did nothing wrong with SQ. I moved in at 154.50 right here. I didn't quite get it here. I got it a little bit higher than that. Again, I was expecting it to move over the highs. It did move over the highs. You always buy it at the point where you expect it to move over the highs. I was also looking at a $1 to $1.5 stop loss. That's why I was looking for a target which would be close to 156. Actually said I'm going to take a partial over 155.80, which it did move over. So why didn't I take my partial? And why did I have a loser waiting for it to come down as it did? And then I've got my $1.5 loser. I did get that. So the thing is, I'm trying to get a one-to-one risk reward. It's usually, once I get to the point of the one-to-one risk reward, I'm trying to get a bit more because, one-to-one risk reward is great, but my average trade is usually much better than a one-to-one risk reward. My worst target would be one-to-one risk reward. I mean, sometimes, yeah, things happen, market changing direction, things like that. So you don't even get your one-to-one risk reward, but that's quite rare. Most of the time, I would get more than one-to-one risk reward because I'm letting my winners run a little bit more than I expected them or targeted them. So as it happened here, it just touched my target and a few cents higher, maybe 9 cents higher, and then pulled back down. I keep waiting for it to continue its uptrend because it should, but stocks don't always behave the way we like them to behave. And SQ sadly decided to change direction here and it's trending lower now. So I've got my loser, but I did not do anything wrong. I did get to the first target. I mean, I assumed it's going to get there, so I was right. End result, I have a losing trade, but I played it the right way. So I've got There's nothing wrong with what I did. It's just that this time it just didn't work out. It worked out nicely in FSLY second trade, W2C first trade. So in fact, I've got two winners and one loser. Actually more than that. I've got two winners in FSLY after adding for my second trade, another winner in WDC, and one loser in FSLY, my first trade, and one loser in SQ. That's why I'm nicely in green territory. So it's all about doing the right thing over and over and over again. I could have a loser in SQ, but if I do the right thing for my next 100 trades, and I'm gonna have a winner over 60% of the time, my average is like 68%. So if I'm gonna have at least 60% over the time winners, and keep on doing the right thing, although I had a loser in SQ, that would make me a successful trader. So it's just repeating what you do. And don't discourage if you got a trade like SQ, which is going the wrong way, and try to get a little bit more. Just think about what you did. And if I'm thinking and I'm coming to the conclusion that, well, I've done the right thing in SQ, there was nothing wrong there, I probably need to review it a little bit more, like maybe my stop loss was not the right place or anything like everything like, I mean, something like that. But basically, if you keep doing the right thing over and over and over again, you should make money in day trading. But if you get discouraged from a trade like SQ, and then of course, the right thing was adding in FSLY. So I guess I've done more right thing than wrong thing today. And the end result, of course, is $15,000 up. I had a $6,000 loser yesterday, losing day yesterday. So it's not all green, but my average definitely green. So I've seen earlier that we had like 68% of you guys in green territory today, which is great. Love that number. And I'm happy that you guys are sharing this and enjoying the day. I mean, most of you. And I'm looking forward for tomorrow. So have fun. Just a heads up, I'm going to be away next week. And probably the week later, I'm not sure really. I'm just getting into my car from Berlin and trying to reach Copenhagen. I don't know if I'm going to reach Copenhagen, but that's my destination. I'm just going to stop on the way somewhere. It's going to be north of Europe tour, which I'm going to start next week. And I'm just going to be away for a while. So I don't really know how long. I don't know where I'm going to stop. Target Copenhagen. Because it's cooler there and it's getting really warm right now in Berlin. So that's it for me for today. I'll see you all tomorrow. I'm still trading tomorrow. So enjoy the rest of your day. Bye, traders. Thank you for watching our video. Before you go, we invite you to join the TradeNet trading room for a free 14-day trial. TradeNet has educated more than 30,000 professional traders worldwide since 2004, and its trading room is one of the world's leading trading communities. Click here to start your free trial. If you like this video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel where you can view many more stock trading videos. Questions or comments, please submit them below.